Coach, can you just break down Sam's performance with 14 points and 13 rebounds?
I thought she played really, really well. It's what we needed. We talked about this, about how we've got to continue to get better at rebounding the basketball. And I thought tonight she really did a nice job on the glass. And, you know, we know Sam can score, and she's got to be able to score for us. We've got to continually find a second and third scorer. And we have players that have that ability to score. We just got to get them to keep getting in the gym and getting confident with their shots.
Coach, holding them to a season-low 26% shooting, what was it you were looking to take away from the Yellow Jackets and cause them to shoot that season-low?
Well, I thought defensively we were outstanding. We did a nice job of not letting the post just get the ball, you know, right on the low block. Our goal was to try to force them out a step or two. And then you have to defend their cutters. Their guards do a great job when the ball goes into the post of cutting to the basket, and we didn't fall asleep one time. We did not give up an easy layup off a handoff or a dumb pass, which we told him was going to be very important. You know, defensively, when I go back and break this down, I'd really like to see what we held them to on first shots. I mean, you look at it, we held them to 44 points, and they got 15 second chance points. So I'd really like to see what we did on their first shots, and that's something that we're going to talk to our kids about. You work so hard to defend, but you got to finish it with a rebound, and that's one that's it's going to bite us in the butt here sooner or later.
That was a big high profile game you played Thursday night, and it's always a risk your team would come out the next game and not be sharp. That wasn't the case. Why do you think that was?
Well, I think we've got a lot of veterans who have played in a lot of big games. You know, for us to go up there and play at Notre Dame, of course, it's a huge game. You know, it's 1-2, but it's not the first time that these kids have been in those ball games. Especially when you've got just about everybody returning play in the Final Four. You sit there, you play your Sweet 16 game, you know, you realize you've got an Elite Eight game next. So our kids have done a really nice job of being able to handle one game at a time and then move on to the next.
Coach, Georgia Tech, a very heavy rebounding team. How did you prepare for that in practice?
Well, I mean, we just talked about putting a body on somebody. You got to put a body on somebody. You have to find somebody. And we're just not, I mean, we're putting a hip into somebody, and we're not getting them on our backside. And that's what we've got to get better at. It's like we kind of ride them. We're just going to sit there, stand on your side, and push you. The problem is, as soon as that ball hits the glass, the rim, and goes, I have no advantage anymore. So that's what we keep talking to our kids. You got to put somebody on your backside.
Coach, there was a marked difference in fouls in this game compared to the game Thursday night. Was this just a different strategy by you all, or something you all worked on in practice?
No, I mean, we constantly work on trying to guard without fouling. We still had too many of our starters on the bench in the first half because of two fouls and silly things. And those are things you have to work on. So like I told AC, you know, the first foul on the little loose ball, whatever, you know, it's a foul. I might not like the call, but they called it. But then the second one she picks up, she slaps down on a post player when the ball's in her hands. And it's like, you can't pick up that one. And that's what I'm trying to get them to understand. All five fouls aren't bad calls. So what you've got to figure out is, how can you eliminate the ones that you get just by, you know, not moving your feet? You reach in. You don't get in position to box out. You've got to eliminate those one or two. So now, even if there's three that are 50-50 and they all go against you, you've still only got three fouls. So that's what we're really working on.
Coach, on the rebounding issue, is it more an issue with the forwards and the post players not posting up, or is it guards as well? Because I know you've talked about in the past where if you're able to block out their leading rebounder, if the ball hits the floor, that gives your guards a chance to get it. Is it Is it that, you know, just where your guards aren't able to get some of those loose ball rebounds?
Well, it's yeah, I mean, that's part of it. It's like I keep telling our kids. I mean, like Jazz is, you can't play 21 minutes and not come up with one rebound. I mean, one's got to bounce in your hands. And, you know, it's what I talked to him about. You got to be on the floor. You've got to come up with a rebound because there's plenty of them to get. And that's what I keep challenging them with. Even our point guards, everybody has to rebound our team. At the defensive end of the floor, everybody has to commit and buy into it. At the offensive end, we do send somebody back. So, like, if I'm being the one that's being sent back every time, I'm not going to get an offensive board. I'm fine with that. We don't send anybody back on the defensive glass. So, everybody's got to buy into wanting to make this a team rebounding effort. It's nice to be 14-1 and trying to figure out how you're going to rebound. It's better than being 1-14 and trying to figure it out. So, I mean,
they've got a freshman that.
Well, I got a stat sheet, final stat that says 14-1. Isn't that your job? Well, I'm just reading what you give me. Can't find good help, people. Wait till I call Andrews. Tell Matt. God. No, I sure appreciate it. Anything else from anybody? All right. Thank you all for coming out. What a great crowd, too. I mean, I thought it was fantastic. I know whenever we come out and our end zones are filled that it's a great crowd, and I thought they were fantastic tonight. Thank you, guys.